If you were an evil mastermind and you said, where could I put nuclear waste that would really scare the bejesus out of people? It's hard to think of one that's worse than San Onofre, a nuclear generating station.
This is the San Onofre Nuclear Generating Station, just outside of San Clemente, California. It's been closed since 2013, but its operators are struggling with a problem that most plants in America share. All the spent nuclear fuel it ever generated is still trapped, right here.
So the thing you notice immediately about this plant is its location. You've got the Pacific Ocean right there. You've got the Interstate 5 freeway just over that hill. You've got LA and San Diego within 75 miles and 8.5 million people living in the area. And smack dab in the center of it all is tons and tons of nuclear waste.
Back when it was running, the San Onofre plant could power 1.4 million homes at a time. But now, the reactors are retired, and the plant's operator, Southern California Edison, is preparing to dismantle it completely. So to see this whole multi-billion dollar process firsthand, we took a tour of the power plant. Our guide is Ron Pontus, Manager of Environmental Decommissioning Strategy. And except for all of the security, the seagulls, and us, the place is pretty empty.
Behind us is the containment building for Unit 3. Inside that building is the nuclear steam supply system, which consists of the reactor, steam generators, pressurizer, and reactor coolant pumps.
That's where the fuel would normally go. Bundles of hollow metal rods that are packed with little pellets of uranium. Inside the reactor, uranium atoms split apart in a chain reaction that produces heat.
That's where the heat is generated, that is transmitted to the steam generators, to make steam, to turn the turbines, which makes electricity for our customers.
Only, this plant hasn't produced electricity for years, ever since one of the steam generators sprung a leak.
It is a done deal. SoCal Edison has gotten tired of waiting to reopen the troubled San Onofre power plant, so today, the utility announced it is shutting it down for good.
Now, the plant operators need to decontaminate the site, demolish the structures, and generally tear everything to the ground. First, though, they have to do something with all that fuel. Fresh fuel isn't actually all that radioactive. It gets more radioactive after it spends time in a nuclear reactor. Because that chain reaction that generates heat, it also makes other radioactive atoms like cesium-137, strontium-90, and plutonium-239. About half of the cesium and strontium decay in 30 or so years. The plutonium, that takes longer. Like 24,000 years longer. These days, the spent fuel starts cooling off in cement-lined pools of water. After a few years, it's moved to dry storage, air-cooled steel containers inside massive concrete blocks. Eventually, they'll move all the waste into those blocks. They're lower maintenance, and they're supposed to withstand floods, earthquakes, tornadoes, airplane collisions, you name it.
It requires no pumps or active systems to support it. As long as we keep this inlet and outlet free of any debris or blockage, this system will continue to operate.
That's good because that's where the spent fuel is gonna have to stay for the foreseeable future.
What we are faced with here is a national problem. Every commercial plant in the states is faced with the same problem. There's nothing to do with the fuel because the federal government's not performing.
San Onofre's first reactor powered up in 1968 at the height of nuclear energy's prime and the height of the energy industry selling America on how safe and powerful it was.
The heat output of 1 pound of uranium can equal the heat output of 70 tons of coal.
There were promises that one day, atomic energy would be too cheap to meter, that it would power the world by the year 2000. But for all that promise, there just wasn't a solid plan for the waste.
One could argue maybe we should have thought about this as a nation before we started building nuclear power plants, but by this time, the horse is already out of the barn.
That's Rob Nicoleski, a reporter at the San Diego Union-Tribune who's been following the story at San Onofre for years.
In short, the reason why the spent nuclear fuel stays at San Onofre is because the federal government has dropped the ball.
For decades, the plan has been to bury the waste underground. The government was supposed to start accepting spent fuel in 1998. And the site it settled on was Yucca Mountain in Nevada. Nevada politicians hated that idea.
Beginning this year, the story takes a new and yes, an ugly term, which the press and others tagged months ago, the Screw Nevada Bill.
So the plan has been stuck in limbo for decades, and nuclear power companies have been suing the government for missing that deadline. Meanwhile, nuclear plants keep operating. They produce about 20% of America's electricity and 2,200 tons of waste each year.
This is probably not the ideal place to store spent nuclear fuel. We would all agree on that. But while it's here, we will fulfill our obligation to manage it safely.
There are a few ways out of this situation.
There's been a movement in Congress to restart Yucca Mountain. The Trump administration is in favor of that. There's a bill that is in the House. Then there's this talk about consolidated interim storage. There are two sites they've talked about there.
There's even talk about moving the waste to higher ground near the plant, but farther from the sea.
So there's all these different permutations out there that are basically put everything up in the air.
But in the meantime, the waste is going to sit there in that concrete fuel morgue on the coast. Again, it's safe in those blocks. We stood right next to them and then even swept ourselves for radiation just to be sure. But for people living near San Onofre, it's hard to forget about them entirely.
They go on with their lives. You don't see people freaking out. But on the other hand, though, it's something that hangs over their heads.
We wanted to see for ourselves, so we checked out the beach that the plant sits on. We passed people fishing, walking their dogs, surfing, hanging out, like you'd do on any other beach that isn't next to 1,700 tons of spent nuclear fuel. I asked some of them how it feels to be living in this thing's shadow. They weren't wild about talking on camera, but they had a lot to say. There was a guy walking his dog on the beach, and he actually said that nuclear power is this incredible thing, but storing the waste at the plants is a federal mistake. Another woman was there on the beach with her family. She says she surfs here all the time, but it's still eerie when she takes a wave back to shore, and she sees those twin reactor domes staring back at her.
So during our tour, we weren't the only visitors to the dry storage. There were a ton of seagulls, and the plant is doing their best to keep them away. They've got plastic coyotes patrolling the dry storage, but for as long as it's there, it's probably going to be covered in seagull poop.